Okay, today I'm going to start with the head part of solution. In last class, we have discussed about first thing about the types of solutions we have already discussed. Right? And second thing, we have discussed concentration. Right? In types of solution, we have discussed types on the basis of number of components. And second, we have discussed about classification on the basis of physical state. Right? But the contradictory part is that on the basis of number of components, in this chapter, we are only going to discuss binary solutions. And on the basis of physical state, we are only going to discuss liquid solutions. Am I clear to you all? So in this chapter, we are only going to study binary solution, and along that, in that we are only going to discuss liquid solutions. So moving ahead with the chapter, the first thing which we are going to discuss today is solubility. And as I have discussed, we are only going to discuss about the binary solutions and liquid solution. So first thing which comes when I'm talking about solubility. What is solubility? It is amount of solute which can be dissolved in given amount of solvent at constant temperature. So now we are going to discuss the chapter solubility. And as you can see, what is solubility? We have discussed this in ionic equilibrium last year. So what is solubility? It is amount of solute which can be dissolved in the given amount of solvent at constant temperature. Now, as I have discussed and I have told you, we are going to discuss liquid solutions. Okay? So liquid solutions are of three types. What are those three types? The first type is solid in liquid. Second is gas in liquid. And third is liquid in liquid. So definitely, we are only going to study the binary solution, and in that we are only going to discuss the solubility of these three types of solution. So moving ahead, we are going to discuss first is solubility of solid in liquid. Right? So this is the first part which we are going to discuss, that is solubility of solid in liquid. So we are going to discuss over here what are the factors which affect if I am dissolving any solid into liquid, which are the factors which are going to affect this point. The first factor is nature of solute and solvent. is the first thing which we are going to discuss. Now, before starting discussion of this topic, we have already discussed last year polar and non-polar solutions. Polar and non-polar solutions. On that basis, I'll give you quickly an example. Suppose you are having water, and in another beaker, you are having carbon tetrachloride, CCl4. Right? So, if I'm talking about CCl4 and H2O, please can anybody switch off their mic and answer me among both of them? Which is polar and which is non-polar? You can raise your hand and let me know.
H2O.
H2O is polar, very good. And CCl4 is
non-polar.
Now you can switch off your mic kindly, everybody, please. Now, when I'm talking about non-polar and polar, you are very clear with this concept. And still, if anybody is having doubt, you can just leave the chat. I will again explain polar and non-polar in the next class. Okay. So, point to be noted over here, there is a big say that like dissolves . So this is a statement that states that, or we can conclude from this, that polar solid is soluble in polar solvent. Right? So, if I am putting NaCl to both the solvents, so it is very clear, when I'm adding NaCl to water, it is soluble. Why? Because NaCl is also what? Polar. Whereas, if I'm talking about this condition, it is not soluble. Because my statement goes like that, light dissolves light. So polar is soluble in polar, and polar is not easily soluble in non-polar. So definitely it is very clear from this concept that this solubility is not possible, whereas this solubility is possible. Is it clear to you all? Next thing. So it is from this statement, or from this we can conclude that example that NaCl is soluble in H2O and it is insoluble in CCl. You can do this example in lab also, and you will be clearly seeing that this solubility is possible whereas this is not possible. Very clear to you all? So always remember that polar is soluble in polar and non-polar is soluble in non-polar. So this is the first factor which affects the solubility of solid and liquid, that is nature of solute and solvent. And here nature we are dealing with dipole. You already know we have discussed this part, dipole in covalent bonds. And ionic bonds also we have discussed. Ionic character in covalent bonds and covalent character in ionic bond we have discussed. On that basis we can clearly state that whether the given compound is polar or non-polar. Now, next factor which affects the solubility.
Ma'am, we can write whatever you are writing.
But I'll give you PDF. No need to worry of these notes, whatever okay. I'm teaching. So focus on understanding. Okay. Second. Second factor which affects the solubility of solid and liquid is temperature. Now, we have already discussed in thermodynamics that we have two conditions whenever we are dissolving solid, liquid solution. And there is an equilibrium always there. In that condition, we may have two cases. The first case, when delta H is greater than zero, in this case, the reaction will be what? Endothermic. Second case, right? In this case, the reaction will be what? Exothermic. So, with the help of a reaction, I can give you more clarifically that if I am saying solid plus liquid plus heat okay, this is the first case. Second case, solid plus liquid now, we may have two conditions on the basis of temperature. Either the reaction may be endothermic or it may be exothermic. Again, I can give you an example. Suppose we are dissolving NaCl in water. KCl. The reaction is endothermic. You might have observed in the lab whenever you are doing salt analysis. During that, you dissolve or you make a water extract. And whenever you are making the water extract, you might have observed sometimes your test tube becomes cold. And you have many a times asked me question also, ma'am, why it is becoming cold? And sometimes you might have observed your test tube becomes hot. In that case, we can clearly conclude if the reaction, if the test tube is becoming cold. In that case, the reaction is what? Endothermic. And when your test tube becomes hot, your reaction will be what? Exothermic. An example is, sulfate salts, usually. Okay. Now, in both the cases, the temperature will have a different effect. And what will be the effect in the first case? With increase in temperature. Am I audible and clear to you all? With increase in temperature. If the temperature is increasing, solubility will increase. Or I can say it is directly proportional to temperature for the first case. Whereas in the second case, if the temperature increases, the solubility will decrease. So hence, it is very clear when we are discussing about solubility of solid in liquid, with respect to temperature, we will have two conditions. Either it may be endothermic or else it may be a exothermic condition. And on the basis of both the conditions, we can clearly conclude that for endothermic reactions, the temperature is directly proportional to solubility. Whereas for exothermic reactions, the temperature is inversely proportional to solubility. Is it clear to you all? So on this basis, multiple choice questions may be asked or four options will be given to you and will be asked, which is the correct statement for solubility of solid in liquid. So these are the small points. Now you have to be very careful as we have objective questions in the portion more. Earlier it was not the case. So now we have to be very specific with small concepts also. Is it clear to you all? So on the basis of temperature, these are the effects when we are dissolving solid into liquid. The last is pressure. Now my question goes to you all. Any one of you can unmute your mic and answer me. Will pressure affect solubility of solid in liquid? Yes or no? If yes,
no.
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 Why no?
Because it is already compressed.
No. Your answer is correct, but the reason is incorrect. Anyone else?
Yes, can't change solubility.
Or I can say that solids and liquids are not compressible. So hence, pressure has no effect. Am I clear? Okay. Next, we are going to discuss solubility of gas in liquid. Now again, factors affecting. The first factor is okay. In this life, our solute is what? Gas. Now I'll give you a very best example, and on that basis, also assertion reasoning questions may be formed. If I'm saying I have two gases, H2 and HCl. Right? I am planning these two gases to dissolve in water. Which gas will be more soluble and why? Can anybody answer? You can unmute your mic and answer.
Ma'am, HCl.
HCl will be more soluble?
Yes. HCl.
Why?
Because it is polar.
Very good. Because it is polar. Whereas H2 is
non-polar.
Clear to you all? So this is the same factor which we have discussed earlier in solid.
Garam hai wo.
So we can clearly say that again the statement is polar gases or polar gas is more soluble. And here specifically our solvent is what? As compared to? Okay. The point, first point is clear to you all. Now, the second point is temperature. Now here a point clearly, it is again a very important factor to be noted. When I am saying temperature, always temperature will increase, then solubility of gas will decrease. That means I can clearly state that temperature is inversely proportional to solubility in case of gas in liquid. Am I clear to you all? Okay. The next thing is what you can conclude from this statement. That the gas, or whenever we are dissolving a gas in liquid, the reaction will be endothermic or exothermic. You can unmute your mic and answer me.
Endothermic.
Exothermic.
Endothermic.
Endothermic.
Ma'am, CO2 is added to water, then it is cold now.
No, but it is not cold. We put in refrigerator. We are going to come to that point. Just hold your anxiety. Okay. Yes. For the time being, we can conclude that always, it is always the same phase only, that whenever we are going to dissolve any gas into liquid, heat is released. And hence, with temperature, solubility decreases. This is the first point. Now, the second point. Pressure. Whenever I am going to increase the pressure, solubility will okay. Now, for example, you are given a vessel, and in that gas is there. And you are going to compress the vessel. As soon as you are going to compress the vessel, what will happen? This gas will start dissolving into liquid solvent. So it is clearly visible. As soon as I am going to increase the pressure, the gas will start dissolving in the liquid. So as Manish told, that whenever we are going to, or we are preparing the beverages, or we are preparing the cold drinks, in that case, you might have observed, whenever you open the lid of the cold drink, as soon as the pressure is released, all the gas or CO2 bumps out with the liquid. With the pressure, it comes out. Because whenever the pressure releases, the CO2 comes out of the water. So from this, we can state that mass of gas in the liquid is directly proportional to pressure of gas above the liquid. So you might have observed that always you have seen or you have observed the cold drink bottles, there is a lot of empty space in your cold drink bottles. If you have seen it, you are a keen observer, you might have observed that there is a lot of empty space. It is never filled to brim. The reason is this empty space is filled with what? CO2. And CO2 as such, it is not a good soluble, or we can say it is not easily soluble in liquid. So under pressure, it is being dissolved in liquid. This is the first factor. And secondly, you might have seen the instruction on the bottles. After opening the lid, once you have opened the seal, after that you are preferred to put the cold drink bottle into refrigerator. Again, we have discussed this point last year in States of Matter. As the temperature increases, and right now also we have discussed, if the temperature increases, the solubility of gas decreases. So, because we have released the pressure, as soon as we open the lid of the water bottle, we are releasing the pressure. So, to avoid the condition that all the CO2 may not come out, we prefer to keep the cold drinks bottle in the refrigerator, or as I can say, at low temperature. Is this point clear to you all? So on the basis of this effect, we are going to study Henry's law of, or we can say Henry's law for gas in liquid. So and one more reason, this water bottle gap is there because we cannot compress liquid. We can only compress what? Gas. So on that basis, we are going to discuss Henry's law. Very important. Many a times in board this question arises, explain Henry's law and give its significance or application. So we are going to discuss over here Henry's law. Now, what is Henry's law? It states that the pressure of the gas above the liquid is directly proportional to mole fraction of gas in the liquid. So what is P gas over here? It is partial pressure. I think you are able to clear this term. We have discussed Dalton's law of partial pressure last year. So partial pressure of gas above the liquid. So for example, this is a bottle in which liquid is placed over here and CO2 gas is here. So pressure will be applied from here. Never pressure is never started applying from here, this point, from liquid point. It is always applied because gas is invisible. So pressure is started applied from here. So pressure of the gas above the liquid is directly proportional to mole fraction of gas in the liquid. As soon as I am going to increase this pressure, what will happen? This gas which is above the liquid will start dissolving into liquid. So with this, what will happen? The amount of gas in the liquid will increase. Earlier, what was the case? The gas was less as compared to liquid. But as soon as the pressure is being increased, what is happening? The solubility of gas is increasing in the liquid, and with that, what is happening? The amount of gas in the liquid is increasing. Okay, so we can state that this is equation 1. I can state that P gas is equal to constant. So what is this X? It is the mole fraction of gas in the liquid. Be clear with this term. And this K constant is represented as KH in the subscript. This KH is known as Henry's constant. There was a scientist in 1803. He explained this concept, and according to him, he states that the partial pressure of gas above the liquid is directly proportional to the mole fraction of gas in the liquid. Am I clear to you all? Okay. So next thing is, coming to the point, when we are talking about this KH factor, very important factor, many questions can be framed as in multiple choice questions or directly it may be asked. So what is this KH factor? Henry's constant. Now, as already we have discussed that every gas has a different solubility level in water or in solvent. On that basis, it is very clear that for all the solute or all the gases, the KH factor will be different. So it is a constant. So for every gases, you don't have to learn the value for all the gases. It will be given to you. So you have to understand this KH factor depends on what condition? It depends upon and it depends on intermolecular force of attraction. That is a nature of gas. So definitely every gas will have a different intermolecular force. Now please, can anybody unmute their mic and let me know what are the different force of attraction we have discussed last year? Give me types. Yes, Krish, want to try?
London dispersion force.
Okay.
Dipole-dipole moment.
Very good.
Dipole-induced dipole.
Okay. One more type.
Hydrogen bonding.
Very good. Any else? You're missing one more. Which was the art that I taught you.
Van der Waal force.
Better you, whatever forces you have told, it is Van der Waal forces only. What type is missing?
Iron dipole.
It is iron dipole interaction. Very good. Okay, now you all can unmute your mic and see over here. Okay. So as I have given, all the gases will have a different KH value depending upon the intermolecular force of attraction. You don't have to learn these values. You just have to understand what is the relation of this KH and solubility. So as you can see, the important factor which you have to keep in your mind is that KH is inversely proportional to solubility. So definitely, if I'm giving you one question, and it is being asked in 2015 also in board examination, there are two gases A and B having KH value 2.86 and 3.86 respectively. Which gas will have higher solubility in solvent? Who's going to answer? You can unmute your mic again and answer.
Gas A.
Very good. Because it has lower KH value. Is it clear to you all? So this is the first point that you have to be clear with, that KH is inversely proportional to solubility and KH depends upon intermolecular force of attraction. Now, one more example. As we are discussing up till now, we have discussed the factors which affect the solubility of gas and liquid. On that basis, if you see or if you observe, if I'm saying temperature, yes, definitely it is going to affect. If I'm going to increase the temperature, the solubility of gas is decreasing. We have discussed it right now. So on that basis, this KH value will be different at different temperature, yes or no? Yes. So this KH value will depend upon one more thing, that is what? KH is directly proportional to temperature. So keep this point on a check. Whenever temperature is increasing, what will happen? This KH value will also increase. And hence, we have discussed it right now. If the KH is increasing, solubility will be decreasing. Are these points clear? Please be clear with small concepts also. Assertion reasoning questions are mainly based on these concepts only. Okay? So this point is clear to you all? Yes, am I clear to you all? Okay. So next, we have discussed up till now solubility of solid in liquid. Then we discussed solubility of gas in liquid. And in that, we have discussed the important law, Henry's law constant. Okay. Next. You might have observed, if you see in all the old previous year's papers, you will be seeing that many times either the numerical comes on Henry's law or it is given state Henry's law and write its significance or application. So we are going to discuss the application of Henry's law. That is the last part. The first application is, we have discussed it right now, for cold drinks. We are using Henry's law. We are compressing or pressurizing the gas to increase the solubility of gas in liquid. Or we can say CO2 is dissolved in solvent or your cold drinks by pressure. This is the first application. All the points will be given to you in PDF. So you can go through those points, whatever I've taught right now. Next. Second is, at higher altitude, you might have seen or you yourself have noticed that wherever you're going to hilly areas, you feel problem in breathing. Can you tell me why?
High pressure.
Oxygen becomes thinner.
You can unmute your mic and let me know.
Oxygen
solubility
becomes thinner.
Solubility of gas is high. Solubility of gas is decreases.
Why it decreases?
Due to pressure is a means a. What? Pressure is high. No. Yes.
No. Because pressure...
No, pressure is low, that wise.
Very good. The pressure decreases at high altitude And because the pressure is decreasing, and we have studied right now that pressure is proportional to mole fraction of gas, or we can also state this as pressure increases solubility of gas increases. So similarly, pressure is decreasing, solubility of gas decreases, and a person who is going at higher altitude suffers from breathing problem. Is it clear to you all? Any doubt?
Okay. Yes, ma'am.
So one